Energy is essential for development. Energy is key to prosperity. Council of Scientific and Industrial Research, CSIR's focus in the energy sector is to develop new processes for clean and green energy technologies. CSIR is active in replacing conventional fuels with renewable, as well as their storage and facile interconversion. CSIR, Central Electrochemical Research Institute, CSIR, CECRI, is a national laboratory under the Council of Scientific and Industrial Research. Founded in 1948, CECRI has its root in the patriotic fervor of Dr. R. M. Alagappa Chettiar, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru and Dr. Shanti Swarup Bhatnagar. CSIR CECRI's activities with the world-class instrumentation and characterization facilities are directed towards the development of new and improved products and processes, as well as novel innovations in electrochemical technology. With special relevance to electrochemical energy generation and storage, lithium batteries and polymer electrolyte membrane fuel cells find innumerable applications in healthcare, transportation, strategic and space applications, and accordingly, many new materials, systems and subcomponents have been developed since 1995. Abundantly available solar energy and the recently signed COP21 agreement urge the need to store solar energy efficiently. By using the skill sets available at various CSIR laboratories such as CSIR CECRI, CSIR CGCRI, CSIR NPL, CSIR NCL, CSIR IICT and CSIR CMERI networked especially to achieve time-bound targets related to the development of indigenous technologies in the renewable energy sector. One such program is TAPSUN, Technology and Products with Sun Utilization Network, where CSIR CECRI is spearheading the store solar component. The project has generated not only global intellectual property rights IPR in lithium ion battery technology, but has also successfully installed India's first pilot prototype plant for lithium ion cell configurations, namely 18650. Indigenously developed 3.6 volt or 650 mAh lithium ion cells using proprietary materials have been successfully used for powering solar lanterns and hats. Our lithium battery division has a large portfolio of publications and patents covering a diverse spectrum of materials related to lithium ion batteries. A large number of scholars have completed PhD in these areas, and an equal number is pursuing PhD on advanced materials for futuristic systems like lithium sulfur, lithium air and sodium ion batteries. Unlike conventional batteries, redox flow systems are promising to offer affordable energy storage options for solar and wind energy generation. CECRI focuses on the development of affordable materials for energy efficient zinc bromide redox flow batteries. A 250 watt redox flow battery has been developed and demonstrated recently, which could be scaled up to 1 kilowatt stack in the near future. In addition, there is an active biodiesel program where CSIR IIP Dehradun and CSIR CSMCRI Bhavnagar are involved. Similarly, R&D contributions on dye-sensitized solar cells, organic photovoltaics and organic light emitting diodes by CSIR NIIST, CSIR NPL, CSIR NCL and CSIR IICT to energy theme are remarkable. Due to our core competence, many global companies and renowned national industrial houses are our clients. Apart from R&D activities, CSIR CECRI offers industrial training programs, skill development workshops, knowledge upgradation lectures and technical services. To mention a few, MS Mahindra Reva, Kinetic Engineering, Reliance, General Electric, Amara Raja, and Exide have active partnership with CECRI, a unique facility, CSIR BP Tech, Battery Performance Testing and Evaluation Center, which has got NABL accreditation. Batteries are subjected to different types of tests as per national, international and in-house specifications with the state-of-art equipment. Solar energy could be used to generate hydrogen using water electrolyzer. CECRI has developed such a PEM electrolyzer with 5.0 Newton meter cube per hour capacity, and the technology has been transferred to Messrs Eastern Electrolyzers Private Limited, New Delhi. Another important area where CECRI has carried out remarkable work is about the conversion of waste to wealth. For example, food waste could be converted into electricity by microbial fuel cells. New electrocatalysts are being developed to improve the efficiency and energy generation using appropriate microbes. The power output obtained from our MFCs is sufficient for running digital clocks, lightening low power LEDs and powering calculators. As a sequel to CECRI's groundbreaking titanium substrate insoluble anode technology, using indigenously developed oxygen depolarized gas diffusion cathode, substantial energy saving in the production of chlor-alkali has been demonstrated at the 45x45 cell assembly. Contributions of CECRI towards energy efficient corrosion monitoring for RCC structures includes protection of material wealth of this nation. For instance, Kudankulam Nuclear Power Plant Units 3 and 4, constructed by Indo-Russian technology, has sought corrosion remediation measures from CECRI. Herein, CECRI's integrated corrosion monitoring sensor gadget, accessible through a custom-designed mobile app, is yet another revolutionary approach to assess the health of high-rise civil infrastructures. Similarly, triboluminescent paint impregnated sensing matrix coated on the RCC structure will help to identify the origin of the crack using an indigenously developed triboluminescence camera, that is TL camera. These products are developed under CSIR-sponsored 12th five-year program originated multi-fund project. With respect to the development of ultra-capacitors for electric vehicle applications through NMEM, attempts are being made to demonstrate the advantages of using ultra-capacitor packs, either alone or as supplementary power sources to rechargeable batteries and fuel cells for electric and hybrid electric vehicles.
In the area of energy, one very significant development which is worthy of mentioning is the development of smart solar trees. These smart solar trees basically maximize the capturing of solar power for non-conventional energy utilization, a major ambitious target of our country. And these solar trees, which were recently unveiled and put into operation in Delhi in the CSR headquarters, as well as at the residence of Minister of State for Science and Technology, and working day and night to validate the efficacy of the process, in which in a very small footprint, practically 10% of conventional solar panels, the same energy is trapped and utilized.
Energy sector empowers almost all the industries. Thus, it can be said that the contribution of CSIR in the progress of the nation is remarkable. CSIR, pride of Indian science.